The AK's designer, Mikhail Kalashnikov, was a Red Army tank commander during World War II. In October 1941, he's only 22 when a piece of shrapnel sends him to a military hospital and starts him on a career in weapons design. Kalashnikov's first gun ideas impress his commanders. They reward him with a design team, which includes a young draftswoman, Katya Moisheva. She can help turn his ideas into blueprints. Through months of development, they design a simple, rugged weapon that can withstand any punishment the elements and battle can dish out. And soon, sparks fly between the gun designer and the artist. He writes,
"She applied herself with the most extreme precision to drawing the sketches I entrusted to her. In the end, the AK was the fruit of our love."
The first prototype rifle is produced in the same year Kalashnikov marries Katya, 1947. It's called the Automatic Kalashnikov, the AK-47. It comes too late to fight Hitler, but just in time for the Cold War. When the Red Army launches a competition to find a new rifle, the AK-47 wins, hands down.
One of the designers withdrew when he saw the AK and said, "I can't compete with that."
It's a remarkable achievement for a self-taught engineer. Yet, it is Kalashnikov's lack of formal training that makes his gun so successful. He bucks the trend towards tighter fitting, precisely engineered weapons. The AK-47 is not a great leap forward. It's a deliberate step back. It has just half the moving parts of its American competition, the M16.